That the tour of California was critical of Landis's allegations.
Well, it's a shame that people who get caught and confess have to pinpoint other people. Personally, I think Lance is as clean as they get. I mean, he's been tested more times than anyone, probably more times than almost everyone put together. So I believe Lance is clean. Unfortunately, Floyd's not.
To the finish, and that gives a breakaway rider when it would be pretty much a foregone conclusion. He would be caught with this far to go. As long as he gets off of this ascent safely, he has a chance to win.
He twice lost his back wheel there, Bob, and he's corrected it. He's not afraid to go downhill. Just take a look at his back wheel here. That was one. Now watch this one.
Whoo, babies!
Again, twice. Now, I tell you, he's racing on roads very similar to where he lives in Switzerland, so he might feel quite at home here now, racing down this narrow country descent, bound for the finish. Still a long way to go. It's still 14.8 miles still to ride, so it's a big ask of him.
Yes, indeed. He comes from Bern.
So, my friends, that is why the pros do not like disc brakes. They just do not have the modulation that you get with the rim brakes. Why is that? Because you have heat expansion in the calipers, and that master cylinder up top of those STI units is just not perfected yet. You know, that's just not perfected yet. You saw that. What world tour rider is skidding around corners on a road bike at 60, 70k an hour? You know, the brakes do not work properly. Disc brakes do not work at that level properly. They're too temperamental. Rim brakes for the win. So that's just the deal. That is the dealio. We just have these little disc brakes here, and they just don't work properly. You know, they won't work properly at that level, world tour level. If you're just cruising along, they're okay. They're fantastic. If you're just cruising along, you don't matter a bit of wheel rub. You know, when you put your wheel in there, you have to recenter your calipers. It doesn't rub. But yeah, it's fine. I don't mind that. My gravel bike, it's cool. My mountain bike, it's okay. But you know, if I'm doing the Tour de France, this is what I want. I want a French rim job. You know, if I'm going to France, I want a rim job. I don't want no disc rubbing issues, okay? That's just the deal there. Disc brakes do not work properly in the Tour de France. We've seen it. Lopez, stage one, crashing. That's what happened in Lopez on the wet roads. Remember that? The soap, little soap bath, little soap rub. And he had a soapy bath there. We had Bangkok bath on the road. And boom, grabbed his rear brake, locked up, slid out, bang, crash time. So if it was raining at Hershey's caramel was going down the hill, it would have been Hershey's chocolate all over the road, all right? He probably got some Hershey's chocolate in his pants after his disc wheel was locked up on that corner. I definitely would have, all right? So if you make yourself some Hershey chocolate sauce in your assos, then you go for it. Run disc brakes in the world in the Tour de France. Otherwise, I'm going to rim all the way. And we see that Tadej Pogačar is probably going to win the Tour de France, or Primoz Roglic, or Egan the Vegan Bernal is probably going to win, and they've got rim brakes, the top three, all right? So when every second matters, rim brakes. Martinez won stage 13. Look how slow his time was up the climb. He's 57 minutes down. 57 minutes down. And people are trying to say that he's on a high-performance bike. 57 minutes down. Just saying. And he's a GC rider. So we shouldn't be putting these riders in dangerous situations. That's dangerous enough. Give them rim brakes back. Disc brakes slice and dice, they don't work properly, the modulation's all out of whack. On the mountain bike, yeah, if you want a Shimano, it's good. SRAM, don't even talk to me about SRAM mountain bike brakes. But yeah, these guys should be running flat bar. If you want to run disc brakes, run flat bar Shimano.
And this is Omar Fraile going a little bit too quickly into this corner, and Lopez just losing it, and that's one of the big GC favorites. That's as bad as it can get for the Astana squad.
Oh.
Oh, and there's Lopez. He still hasn't gotten going yet.
Bob, did you see the state of his bike? It was in two bits.
Yeah.
And the radio message had only just come out, of course, but they haven't got the privilege of television like we have. There it is again. Locked up front, locked up back, foot on the ground, straight into the only sign in front of him. Ouch. The front end of his bike snaps off.
All right, that's the deal there. Let's stop the troll faces, Harley. This is Julian Alaphilippe. He should be in yellow jersey now or tomorrow for stage two. He should be in the yellow. And look at this, brakes fail. Look at that, failing. Disc brakes failing. And if he didn't have skill, imagine if that was a noob. That would be over the bars, over the barrier. You know, like just all over the shot. Let's look at Lopez again. This is the danger. Disc brakes, road discs should be banned because these guys are going way too fast. Bang, look at that, just kiss of death to that carbon frame. The frames are too light because I've got to make weight, and because the disc brake weight extra. You know what I mean? So the frames are flimsy and flexy, and they snap, bang. You know what I mean? Just he's so lucky. Roglic is like, guys, man, just chill. You know? That's the thing with disc brakes and the Alaphilippe. Remember this? Look at this bike change. They had to change. You got to. His brakes failed. Look at that. Locked up and crashed him. How dangerous is that? Remco's in hospital now because his disc brakes failed. And now, and look at that. Can't even get the thing off. It's gotten so overheated. It's like smoke's coming off the brakes. And they can't even undo it. So they've got to put the drill down. F1 change gun. And that is trying to put Allen key. It's all seized up. This is a brand new $18,000 Australian SL7 Tarmac S-Works. Made in China. Assembled in Taiwan. And sold to barristers all around the world who think disc brakes are an advantage, and they are if you're riding an e-bike or if you're an Uber Eats rider in London.